place in chapter B, the first one. So, okay, demo one files. We are going to find here the demo one PS1 file. We are going to find this file really simple to read. Actually, I got here is just creating a new resource group. Let's call it test group. So, new resource group name, location, West Europe, and I just put in verbose so we can see something going back. And then I have a new resource group deployment template. I put the resource group name. I put a name here that again is going to be just ignored by the agent portal. Then I have a template file. That is my template file. It's going to be a real simple one. The first one is going to be just creating an availability set and one IP. And I have the my parameter files. That is when I pass the name of availability set and where I should be located. And I have your variables just so we can see that. If you see the first files, we have the template file. The template file, you have the schema that is not updated, the content version. What is content version? It works, for example, if you have many versions of the same file and you want to make sure that, imagine that you are upgrading your template and you want to make sure that the version that you are calling from this location the actual version of the template. So when you are specifying linked templates, you can say, okay, I want this template to be version 1.2.3, for example. So it makes sure that if the file that is downloading is not the version 1.2.3, that is going to fail when getting that. So here are the parameters. We have that here is a location method. This is a type only metadata. I'm going to show you guys after. Why this is important is just more if you are going to publish this template or use the one-click deployment for Azure, this metadata is important when you actually create the button. It actually uses that metadata to describe to who is using your template, what is that. One other thing that you can put on metadata is the display value, that is like what's the name that is going to be for this value instead of a location method if you want to have something other. This is allowed values. This have only two allowed values. We are going to see how to test the templates, and we are going to see what is important. The default value is like what I put as default for this thing. It was important to actually put that. Resource prefix is just a one that I'm using here, and you guys can use anything that you want. And as you can see, this resource prefix does not have default value. Because it does not have a default value, if I try to create that with a template that does not have that, it's going to ask for me for the value for this resource prefix. So it's something that's required. If you have something that's required, you just need to take out the default value and it's going to assume that it's required. Let's go back to parameter file. If I go back to the parameter file, again, it's just a really simple file that I have here, the parameters, and the allocation method, and the resource prefix. Again, something really simple, just a normal JSON. One thing that we all love about JSON is that this does not allow you to put trailing commas and does not allow commentaries. So if you are trying to do that, you are going to suffer any comments or something like that you want to put in the file, you are going to need to put somewhere else and put it on an empty file because JSON does not allow you that. And they follow the conventions of JSON. Actually, if you put trailing commas, it does not care. It actually is able to execute the templates correctly. But if you try to validate the template only, it actually is going to say to you that this template is invalid because it's not a valid JSON. But again, if you try to execute, it's going to execute correctly. But I do not recommend to actually not follow that because if you already test your templates and that's something that I recommend you to do, if you already test your template, you already need to do that. Okay, so if I get back to my PowerShell. And I execute this demo on PS1. Oh, one thing that's actually going to be deprecated, you're going to see here. Switch Azure Node, Azure Resource Manager. So this is a command that I always need to actually do right now because Azure Resource Manager is the only module for PowerShell that actually have two different modes. So it's not stateless, so this is actually quite confusing, especially when you look at documentation of these things. So what has been a huge discussion on the community of PowerShell is like how we are going to do that, how we are going to keep different versions of the same command. For example, new VM, new Azure VM is the same command for the old one and for the new one with different parameters. So it's a little bit different to actually execute these commands. How can you have both commands on the command line at the same time? So what they decided to do is every command that I present to you guys today is going to be renamed, and it's going to be, everything is going to have two letters more. So it's going to be Azure RM and deployment, Azure new Azure RM deployment resource group deployment. It's just a giant one that's going to be bigger than here. So they just add two more letters to that, so it's going to be this way. Now if I use the demo one, you're going to see if internet opens. I hate this part. If you're doing a presentation in the cloud, it's very okay. Okay, first thing is create a resource group, let's call it test group location West Europe. It says to me here that the resource group is created with success. And then it's actually trying to deploy, create a deployment. It actually says the name here, just in the portal that it doesn't show the name. So we actually created a public IP address and availability set. Availability set is the simplest thing that you can create on the template. So if you're starting, just creating new things on the template, always start with availability set because it's the thing that provisions fastest of all. It actually takes 2 seconds to actually provision or stuff like that. It's just a logical thing, it's not actually anything that exists. And a public IP, for example, took us, I think, around 9 seconds to actually provision a new IP for us to use. So here we have the results. Again, the deployment name, what are the parameters that I passed for that. Again, this is coming from my parameters file. And my mode that I actually did for that is the more incremental. So I don't delete the things that are there already on this test group. Okay, this is quite a simple one. Let's get back. I can get back to this one. This one is the first demo. Okay. Test Azure Resource Group deployment. It's going to be test HRM resource group deployment. But this is everyone do test, okay? Yeah, we do. We are heard about that all the time from developers. We need to do unit tests and we need to do that. And actually infrastructure, one thing that I was surprised when I actually moved to actually work more of that is that how much we don't do tests on infrastructure. You just say, okay, it's working now, don't touch it, let's keep it that way and don't even try to actually deploy something. So we don't do test infrastructure, and this is something that I have seen a lot, especially talk with another guy that I'm working there. Say, okay, I have this script here, I run it and it runs correctly, that's it. I say, how have you tested that? Yeah, no, I just run that and that's the test, you know. When you are working with like really small things, it's okay. And when you are deploying once in 2 months, every 2 or 3 months, it's okay to actually run it. If it fails, you actually have 1 or more months to actually fix that. But when you're trying to deploy your infrastructure every day, for example, one thing that we are trying right now is to auto-scale with new deployments. So if you are putting a deployment red, green things, for example, you need to actually deploy your whole infrastructure every time that you deploy application. So if you don't test that, any change on the infrastructure is something that's unpredictable. So to actually have a little way to actually predict that is this test Azure Resource Group deployment. The bad thing is that this does not work, okay? It works kind of, okay? If you have simple deployment templates and deployment templates with just really easy to spot errors, okay. This is going to work, you're going to see that, and you know it's going to be easy to spot. But if you have anything that's more complex, the test Azure Resource Group deployment is just not going to work. Because you are going to have link in deployment templates, and then it does not work with link in deployment templates. And then you are going to have length expressions, and does not work with length expressions. It's getting better, because when I first tried that, it did not work even with concat expressions. Now it's working a little bit better. But again, even with these simple tests, okay, you can spot a lot of errors already. So I think it's important for us to. Parameters. This is something that's really odd, because actually, to test a template, it requires you to have a resource group name. What doesn't make sense, because why you're just trying to see if the template is going to work, why I need to have a resource group created to actually make sure that my template is going to work. Resource group name actually verifies that this resource group is up and running, so you need to have some resource group there to actually test. I got it because what he actually tests is, for example, the storage account that you are trying to create. If the storage account is not there already, or there's not somewhere using that storage name. So these things, okay, they need to validate with the cloud, so they need to go and push the template there to actually validate. But it's something that they need to work on. We don't need to have this dependence of having one name actually just to test. Template fire, template parameters fire, and mode. Exactly the same thing that we always really have with the other one. Okay, so I'm going to show you guys how the test can actually fail. So it's a real simple test that's going to fail. Okay. Hope you guys can see that. Okay. Let's go back to level 2. My demo 2 here. To someone that's interested, I'm using this assumed code here, just at home, but same way. Okay. Here I'm using the simple command. I'm using the same way, test resource group, creating the new resource group, new resource group, and testing the resource, passing the template file, the parameter file. Okay. One thing that I'm passing here on this demo PS1 and the demo correct is just the different is the parameter file. In the demo 1, I'm passing the wrong parameter file, and the other one I'm passing the correct. What's the difference on the parameter file? You just remember that I put in my first parameter, the template, the allowed values. The allowed values for the allocation method are dynamic and static. One thing that I'm putting here is that I put in the allocation method to be a strange value. So anything that is not on my allowed values is going to be appearing here, as for example this strange value. So if I try to go now and to execute that, here, GPS1, it's going to say to me that it has something there already. And as you can see here, it actually says to me, this is just to create the resource group, okay, this first thing here, it's actually trying to create the resource group again. So actually he's trying now to do the test group, and he says, code invalid template, saying the apply template validation failed, provide a fail for allocation methods, and 130, column 30 is not valid. It's not the best, you know, error that you can have. It could just say that the value is not specified on the allowed values, but again, it's just at least one error that you got saying, okay, your allocation method that you put is not the correct one. So you can actually go there and fix the allocation method. As you guys can see here, I can fix here the allocation method, or I can go to my parameter files. It's just allocation method put as dynamic, as it's one of the allowed values. If I go back and run, right, this one. Okay, it puts to me the template's valid. So actually, you just look for this template's valid validation again. It's not the best test in the world, but it's going to save you for a lot of troubles, at least the small ones or something that's. Okay, I forget to put a variable or reference a variable that does not exist or something like that. That is actually going to give you these small errors that you normally get in that. Okay, now you guys saw some things that were quite simple ones. here. If I go to task group here, and you're going to see the last template here, this is on the portal. So you can see the last template was the one of with the IP and the web being set. I can go get back here to the portal, and I'm going to see my IP and my web being set there. Okay, if I try to deploy something more complex, okay, you're saying, okay, this guy is talking a lot there, but the only thing that he created is a template and a web being set. I can get that in 5 minutes, do that by hand. Okay, what's the value on having that? So let's go to the demo tree. Okay, on this demo tree I have so many things that seriously I don't even know what I have here. So I know that I have some of our being sets, one Redis cache, some website with Go enabled, and I think I have virtual machine. I have 25 of our being sets on another thing. So I've been deploying, I think, around 40 to 50 things here. And it's just one huge file. There's like data disk for different size of the machines. And I don't know if I'm hitting the point on Linux here. So yeah, it's like a lot of different things that I'm deploying. I'm going to show you guys something more complex after, about more structured. This is just a way for, it's a virtual network with different subnets on that. So it's a lot of things together, just to prove that we can actually deploy something that is relatively complex. So you are going to see here everything that's creating. So this is the number of available sets it's creating, and you see virtual networks, storage accounts, public IP address, server farms here. Have virtual network here, storage account, network security groups, and all these. So all these are being created with just one click, and in a way that you can actually manage using a resource group. At the end, I'm gonna actually hit 100 machines just to prove that it actually can create a lot of servers. So okay, this is something we, for example, this is an extension that I'm creating, like WinOps Web. That is just Go language. So WinOps Go language, that is just an extension to support Go inside the website. This normally is going to take you like 5 minutes just to figure out where should I click and this click hell that you need to do to actually find out where is actually the Go language there. So this is something that is going to take a little bit of time. So site extensions, for example, Go language is running here. I provisioning on Windows machine here, and all the things is running. So this is just something that was a little bit more complex. Okay, too complex. Okay, that was something that is beyond what you actually want in just one resource template. So how can I manage my infrastructure not be that messy, you know, not be that many things integrated? And how can I give this some maintainability, okay? I want to be creating the private templates, but I don't want to have this huge 5,000 lines JSON file that everyone touches, and you end up with the same thing that we have in the server at the beginning, that you say, okay, we have this deployment template, but no one touches it because you don't know how it works in the end. So be careful when you're going to touch it. And so to help on this maintainability, we have what's called linked templates. Linked templates is just a new template that we are going to use. That, for example, I want this template to be just to create virtual networks. Okay, so I use this template inside another template when I need to create a virtual network. I just use this template to create a new virtual network. I have all the things that I needed to create my base Windows machine. I put this in a separate template that should be just created with base Windows machine that receives 3 or 4 parameters, and I use this template inside another one. Say, okay, create for me 20 Windows machines, create for me 3 Redis caches and all this, and can link this template to actually make it easier and more maintainable to do that. Let me show you guys how to use this linked templates. And here from this one. Actually, as you see, it's quite fast to actually create the things. Let me just show you guys. That's good. here have a lot of resources now. It's just availability center dedicated, network interface, website with Google. So I just responded now that you guys are not seeing anything. So here are the things that I have created here. So all these have been created, the same test group that we were looking before, but have created Redis cache, some availability sets, network group, group IPs, virtual network, websites, website farm, and all this. So it's quite a complex one that was created, again, just with one file. If we go look now, if I go to the demo 4, is the same thing that I have now, but as you can see, I'm using what is called a template URL, okay, that's for virtual network, and what I'm creating here, inside resources, I'm using a resource called deployments, of the type deployments, that is actually linking another URL, and this is a content version, as I told you guys. If you have different versions or you update that, there's a way for you to keep track which version are absolutely sure that you are using here. And here are the parameters that you have for this version. So virtual machine, network name, virtual network name, and all these location and all that. Again, the parameter file is quite similar. So I'm actually going to deploy that to virtual networks with something easy. I'm just going to change here test group in test group 2, just in case of the other one. Not finished yet. So okay, if I try to create demo for PS1, what you're going to see different here is that instead of me creating all of the things, I got to see here just the deployments as being one of the resources I'm creating. So instead of you seeing here that I'm creating a network interface and create subnets and all these things, the only thing that you're going to see is say, are you creating a deployment of a VNet? That's a deployment of a virtual network on your website. So here, the deployment of virtual network has been succeeded. And these are the things that actually it creates for you. Actually, the parameters that I passed and the things that it creates. So go here back to assessments, tests, test group 2. And as you can see here, I created a virtual network with some subnet on that. So again, just a way for you to make it simple to actually create the things instead of having and make that easier to maintain your deployment templates. Okay, let's speak now. So, I think now is topics for other talks. Just, yeah, Kevin?
Does it do that in parallel?
Yeah, it does that in parallel. It does. I'm going to show the case of 100 machines now, and you're going to see that he creates the 100 machines in parallel, and the deployment interface is in parallel too. And you can specify one parameter, specific parameter that depends on, let's say, for this to execute, I depend on having this being finished. So this depends on what actually needs to coordinate that he's not going to execute these ones in parallel, that he can just execute this one after he finish this other resource group. So it actually takes care of that for you. So watch us, that is something that actually keeps you on the way. For example, the length function that does not work correctly, the 15 character limits for the machine name for Windows that actually is come up on a lot of times. Provision the machines, I could give just another talk really fast about that, like how to use the DSC and testing the templates and hidden types, that's things for another talk. Again, we are hiring. We really are trying, seriously, we need some people. And questions here or later if you guys want to come for us. Thank you, guys. Because I promised that I have this demo form.